Thank you for watching Chop Saki Cinema, your 100% daily dose of Wata in your diet. I'm Josh.
I'm Roger.
I'm Will.
And today we're talking about the martial arts Shaw Brothers classic, Five Deadly Venoms, which right now, reading just the description from Amazon.com, the dying master of the powerful Poison Clan assigns his final martial arts student one last epic quest, and not really, to find his five most mysterious and dangerous disciples, each trained in a different fighting style, and bring them together to root out a conspiracy that would divide and destroy the entire clan, i.e. Dollar Dollar Bills.
Yeah, epic, convoluted, yeah, whichever. 20 of one, you know.
That works.
10 of the...
I mean, this is considered, like, by a lot of Chop Saki fans to be one of the classics of Shaw Brothers in particular, but mainly just the Chop Saki genre.
Oh, and oh, is it ever?
I mean, it has a, I don't want to say paper thin plot, because you kind of figure out who everybody is.
Yeah, I mean, they're
the only guys that dress different in that small little town.
I know, like,
it's like the whole thing. I was like, how do we know who's who? I'm guessing we look for the guys with the very illustrious ponytails.
Yeah, really. Boom, top knot.
Illustrious, right. Ponytails or sweet, sweet mutton stashes.
Yeah. This is true as well.
Because the thing is, I mean, that is a drive. They established very early that the master, who's getting ferociously baked, literally at the beginning of this movie, he is soaking in a clay pot, and he's just like, oh, God, my student, cool me off. My boys are on fire. And he tells them, you have to find out who they are, but they have different names. Oh, okay. Well, that kind of sucks. But even more difficult, I don't know what their names are.
And I've never seen their faces. And I've never talked to them. And none of them ever met each other except for 1 and 2 and 5 and 6.
Actually, it was my theory that the old man was kind of senile and he actually just forgot their names.
Probably true also.
So it was like, because, yeah, 4 and 5 apparently knew each other. And
1 and 2.
Maybe. 1 and 2 have met before.
Yeah.
Were met before they took up training. So that basically means 3 was the only one that no one had ever, like, knew who the hell he was. So, yeah.
And of course, then, I mean, really, it's the five deadly venoms, but this student, who I have dubbed Tadpole, the sixth kind of sort of mildly inconveniencing venom.
The sixth slightly dangerous venom.
I mean, that's the whole thing about the student is that the teacher taught him a little bit of all five of the students' martial arts styles.
But he hasn't quite mastered it.
In fact, the vibe I got is, well, basically, son, you suck at everything. Yeah. But at least,
so I'm going to teach you a little bit of everything that you're actually good at.
I'm going to send you off
you
on
still
this
suck
quest.
At everything else.
I'll send you off on this quest. Hopefully you'll die because you're trying to fight five masters. And you're not really a master of anything.
And then really, this is the last that we see of this teacher the entire movie. Yeah. You presume that he dies off camera.
Yeah.
Because
of all the hot pot baths.
And really, again, we try to keep... Well, our reviews are as spoiler-free as we can make them. Because really, we want you to, if you enjoy this, to go see the movie and enjoy it. But I mean, really, you're right. The plot, it's not a very convoluted plot. I mean, it's...
You'll probably figure it out.
And for the most part, apparently... These five students were not trying to hide, other than the one in particular, aren't trying to hide really hard. Like, I mean, for God's sake, Snake has freaking snakes on his bracers.
Yeah, it's kind of a...
Oh, my God.
Kind of
yeah, when you first meet Centipede, he tosses a little Centipede statuette into the room before he introduces himself to
before
Snake.
Before he jumps in the room.
Yeah, I was just like... I remember Josh's I was like, I'm going to say that's Centipede. I was like, you would be correct.
And to mention Centipede's training sequence in the first, they're dropping plates on him. So I think that's where Disturbed got it.
Dropping plates on that ass.
Yep, he's busting plates.
And I mean, one thing is, I mean, really, as far as the kung fu, it's really solid chop socky kung fu, especially with the whoosh, whoosh, fully English.
And the speed up camera.
Yeah, they speed up a little bit.
But I mean, each member
that's
has
crazy.
A,
doing that
each
hard,
one of the
really.
Five Venoms have their own distinct style. Like Snake has a little like prong finger strikes. Centipede has. He's supposed to be the fastest, so they speed his ass up real fast.
Yep.
Especially when he starts going into it, so there's a...
And then there's Lizard. Lizard climbs walls, so... The most wire work was probably done on Lizard out of all five. I mean, there's one part, you see Lizard hanging on the wall, and you can see the wire pulling up his belt.
Yep.
God, that was awesome, but it's still funny.
Tadpole, all natural.
And,
say,
and like,
you can never
like,
see why this is a cult classic, dude.
Oh, yeah, like all Shaw Brothers movies, the costuming pretty kick ass.
Really bright,
and especially the fact that it's obvious who the five Venoms are because they have the best looking costumes out of anyone in the movie.
Pretty much. The cops bad, as in every Shaw Brothers, corrupt most.
Yeah, because basically when. At one point, yeah, you realize that they are not above, like, torturing victims for, like, excuse me, not victims, prisoners for confessions.
Yeah.
And then at one point, the judge goes, but torture is illegal. Yeah, but you tortured a guy in court to get a confession.
That's true.
That there are law officers, like, being bribed.
Judges can be bought, you know, whichever.
It's like Minfa, the guy confesses, I'm just like, I kept thinking about
myself. You mean snitch bitch Aunt Mempha?
Yes, him.
Yeah.
It was just like, yeah. I was like, yeah, see, we're going to pay you this money, dog, and then everything will be okay. It'll be hunky-dory.
No, it's not.
It
never is.
Anyway,
well, first of all, Mempha, he's a compulsive gambler.
Yeah.
He likes rolling the dice. He likes...
And he seems poor, so he's a bad gambler.
He's a horrible gambler. When one of the characters actually like goes to ask him what he knows, his first instinct is not to bribe him, but to pour hot boiling water over his face.
Because that gets people talking. Or screaming. Whatever.
Maybe talking about other random shit that you want just to get it to stop, but...
True.
And I mean, the thing is, this is actually, for a Chop Socky movie, there's some pretty gruesome stuff in this movie.
Yes, I agree. Although the Technicolor blood was kind of a nice little throwback.
A lot of very thick pink blood. Yep. Yeah, going around.
There's an Iron Maiden. There's an Iron chest piece that's heated up and put on it.
The Iron Vest.
The Iron Collar is what they would call it. Yeah.
Yep. The Iron Vest.
And then
the collar was on the back. The vest was on the front.
I just call it Iron Vest because it didn't have sleeves.
Fair enough.
Yeah, I'll give you that one. But, I don't know. So how do we because we're pretty much like, we've talked through most of this, just talking all kinds of randomness about this entire movie for probably like a little less than half of the video that we're supposed to shoot. So.
Well, no, but I mean, basically, it's like, all right, what did we like about, like the actual kung fu itself?
Yes. Yep.
The
yes.
costuming. I like the costuming.
Definitely like the costume.
Yep.
So much.
That all was... the sets and everything were nice. Cause it's,
actually, yeah.
Yeah, all the sets were really nice because they made a whole Chinese village and everything with their shot on Shaw Brothers studio, which is pretty much like a country of it in and of itself.
Yeah, aren't Shaw Brothers like, it's known for like doing that kind of
yeah, thing. They have like a city, the studio the size of a city, and it's like actually, always open and they're always shooting something on it.
The story of how the Shaw Brothers studio got started actually reads like something out of a Shaw Brothers movie. Run Shaw, the head of the studio, he bought the studio and equipment with gold that he buried to hide from the Japanese during World War II.
Dirt!
Yep.
I mean, he literally paid for his studio with stolen Japanese gold.
Blood money? Go. There's no blood money. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm not talking about blood. What's a blood diamond? This thing's shimmering and pretty. Here.
And the one thing is that, I mean, that is actually the one, even though, like we said, it is quite obvious who four of the five Venoms are, that is apparently like one of the big other driving forces of the plot is.
Find out
who is the Scorpion? Who is the final Venom?
Yep, and if you're wondering, he actually is here. He was just over there.
Yep.
Titan, and again, Chopsaki dog.
The entire time.
Yeah, the official Chopsaki
Temple dog. I was smelling my socks for some reason. I don't get that.
But... Yeah.
Oh,
we call them Snurfles.
Now, as far as all right, Roger. What else did you like about it?
I liked
this way because you're in the little extra light.
All the sets, pretty much all the all the wardrobe was really good. All the martial arts was really good, and pretty much the story doesn't really wait. It kind of moves pretty quickly, so I like that. On some parts, it kind of slowed down a little bit, but I like the kind of the pace of the movie that it was shot and everything. And I like the kind of the tadpole guy, the sixth guy. He's kind of like the D'Artagnan to their musketeers, but he pulls them all together and he gives them all a reason to do whatever they're doing.
Which, if the kid,
don't
I mean,
want to get on the go.
Which is somewhat important.
And Will, what did you, and?
Oh man, I liked everything about it. I mean, that was one of the things was growing up watching it. I just like, I quite literally was like taken back by the whole experience. But I did like, I do love all every Shaw Brothers movie that I've ever seen has wonderful studio designs. The costumes were awesome.
Yeah.
The like except for in some parts with kung fu, it was really good. Except for the parts where, of course, it's meant to be completely cheesy.
Yeah.
When Centipede's going through his little introduction, or when he starts his like fighting style stance, you can tell they obviously speed up the camera just for that.
Yeah.
And that's really cool.
I love his like floor flip kick that never hits anything.
Yeah,
where he does like three times.
Where he does like his triple Lutz axle on the floor.
Just to show you I can do it, and that's why you should be scared of me.
It may not hit you, but I can do it. So
yeah,
scared.
Yeah, I didn't even hit the floor or anything. So what didn't you like about it?
Like something you touched on is that it does tend like to me it kind of dragged a bit in the middle. Really about the part where one of the few actually like heroic characters in the movie gets sent off basically
for craft
selling wolf tickets. I mean, where he gets sent off to the Capitol, and where it's basically a bunch of the characters sitting around just talking about
plotting.
Yeah, just plotting about how horribly they're gonna brutalize this one dude, Toad, basically.
Pretty much, yeah.
And other things I didn't like is the action. I mean, while I liked the development of the whole who is Scorpion angle, I mean, they do have a lot of red herrings in this movie.
Yeah,
a lot. Like at one point, it actually seems like the judge in charge of the city is the Scorpion. Mm-hmm. There's another one of the cops whom is obviously the shady one that's torturing, poisoning guy.
Might be, yeah. There's a guy that boasts that he can kill people without leaving a mark.
Yep.
He could have been Scorpion.
And then, of course, when you actually find out who Scorpion is, not going to say who it is super freaking obvious. Like, well, they have the big final fight between all the Venoms. He just kind of stands back there and just looks sinister and twirls his little stick around. Even to the point where Snake at one point is like, dude, are you going to do anything?
Help me. Why are you just watching? Like,
that and also even they established at the beginning that this is the sixth student story. He's the one that's supposed to find the identity guy. Yeah, about halfway through the movie, he kind of disappears.
Yeah.
You see, like, no sign of this kid for, like... I mean, eventually...
Like, 10, 15, 20 minutes.
I mean, oh, yeah, eventually the kid explains what he's doing. I mean, he was kind of...
drinking and gambling.
Yeah, basically.
He was basically trying to... I guess he was trying to fit in, I guess, would be...
He was also... I mean, he was gathering intel. He was basically, yeah, through process of elimination, trying...
trying to figure out who everybody
was. Mainly, yeah, just the kind of... the slowdown in the middle of the movie and the way they handled the reveal of whom the Scorpion was.
Yeah.
All right, Roger?
Stuff I didn't like about it, the special effects are kind of cheesy, but then again, for the time, they're meant to be. I don't know. I liked it all in all. It did take a kind of a roundabout way to get to certain places. And then, I don't know. I like most of it. Yeah.
Well, I liked a good bit. I didn't like. I was like, it actually, for a lot of the older movies that I saw, actually had a really good story, mm-hmm, but it did really kind of drag.
Yeah.
From top, like, if besides the opening scene, you don't see anything involving like the Venom story, you actually kind of get on track. For like, the movie's like an hour and 37, 38 minutes.
Yeah, yeah.
And about 19 minutes in is when they actually start to get involved in the actual subplot, mm-hmm, of the movie, or the B-plot of the movie, which is, well, actually, would it be the A-plot? Because that's the whole thing.
Well, I mean,
the A-plot would be him to go find the Venoms that are targeting this rich guy.
I thought that would be the B-plot because it's just kind of behind. Because that's the initial... That's,
well, technically, the B-plot, it shows the motivation of why Centipede and Snake are murdering all these people is because they're trying to find the master's friend who
has the money.
Whom is rich. They're trying to find the Wan family treasure.
So, yeah, that would be the establishing of the B-plot. And of course, I did like that, but...
Even though they actually that was kind of subtle how they did it. I mean, oh, yeah, they like kind of played up that even, I mean, you did, like, it was neat seeing that every single one of the Venoms kind of kept it kind of close to the chest, like what they knew about the treasure.
Yeah, even the ones that were friends with it. Not, I did like that. That was another aspect I liked.
Hey, buddy.
Even though, like,
hello,
because like 1 and 2 had met before and before training, and then 4 and 5 had known each other. And we're good friends. And I liked how they kept that aspect. And then I liked that there was an unknown to all of them. So, yeah, like, none of them actually knew every single member. I liked that part. Yeah. But as far as dislikes go, yeah, just in certain parts where it drags a bit, mm-hmm, that's the only parts where I'm just like, eh. I could take a leave, like, because the whole thing with them plotting against one of the other members... You could have summed that up a little better. But other than that, there wasn't really too much I didn't like about it, so...
Yeah.
Okay, just...
And once again, I'm doing this through like, oh my god, my childhood glasses! Those kind of things. So...
And, I would say, this is actually one thing I'd like to do is, since it is the 5 deadly Venoms, who was your favorite Venom? Which one of the 5 was your favorite character? I'd say for me, probably Toad. Because, I mean, he is one of the most, like, atypically, like, he's the atypical martial arts movie hero.
Yeah, he's, like, the good guy. Like, he's the out-and-out good guy.
Where he's basically, he's just like, the right thing is the right thing, and there's no other way to it.
Yeah.
And, I mean, and the thing is, but of course, it's like they say in the Japanese proverb, the nail that sticks up gets hammered down. I mean, they realize that, again, once they decide to use him as a scapegoat, I mean, they beat him down, they torture him, and they break him.
Physically, not mentally.
Yeah, yeah, that and the way that he no-sells, like where he's just like, yeah, whatever, sword strikes, chains, blah.
Especially the man has apparently some vicious bows, and he throws them.
He throws them, bows that bend steel.
He does.
All right, Roger, which Venom is your favorite Venom?
Probably, my favorite Venom's probably Snake. I like the way he didn't really do a lot of violence himself. He just kind of walked and talked to people and kind of did stuff behind the scenes that you don't really, kept him kind of quiet.
Yeah, his game was strong. Like that part where he comes in and he's sitting on his throne with his platinum chains. And I mean, he's just laid back.
Hey, buddy.
He's got like two gold tigers sitting next to him.
This movie's been going on for like an hour and a half. You haven't found me yet.
And I think you're right about that. Is even though, I mean, Snake has his snake technique, but he generally seemed to be most successful at manipulating Centipede to do what he wanted him to do.
Centipede and everybody around him. And to like the cops, the Justice of the Peace. The judges, everybody.
He was the one that bribed like all the cops and manipulated the system.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Will, and which was your favorite Venom?
Lizard. I'm gonna have to go with Lizard. I'm sorry, man. If you can clean the walls, I mean that's gotta be there. And plus, you gotta admit, man, he looked like a straight up Chinese version of like meth.
Method Man. Interestingly enough, since our first episode was Hard Boiled, the guy played Lizard, Philip Kwok. That was Mad Dog.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is a young Mad Dog.
A very young Mad Dog, as a matter of fact.
And I mean, the thing is about
he's going by his opera house stage name.
Kyo Chewy. Yeah.
Yep. But a lot of the martial artists went on to be stunt coordinators later on in life.
Yep.
Where the stunt coordinator for Suicide Squad was actually one of the guys that fought Jackie Chan in City Hunter, the movie.
Oh, cool.
Yep.
And also, one thing I like about Lizard is he was a little bit on the take. He liked getting gifts and presents, but not compared to, like, the blatant, like, witness tampering. Right.
Yeah. I think it was more or less.
And he just did light torture, like pouring hot water on him. He didn't, like, put him in the Iron Maiden or anything.
Yeah. I mean, waterboarding or anything.
As far as like the gifts and stuff, I think it was more or less he didn't mind the
populace liked him.
Yeah, normal people.
Seemed like Everell was like, man, screw the cops. Except they liked Ho.
Yep.
Lizard. Yeah, they really liked Ho.
Yeah, every other cop, they could have been like, you know what, that guy. Oh, ho. Hey, dog, what's up, man?
And then, I mean, even though honorable men, I mean, Centipede, I mean, they had the part where Centipede and Snake effing murder an entire family. Like.
Oh, yeah.
You don't see it until, like, later, but.
Oh,
yeah.
And, I mean, did you see the bodies afterwards? I mean, they got, like, big-ass handprints.
Footprints. Broken, like, different bones. And yeah, shout out to the funeral guy, the coroner,
Medical examiner.
He pokes the body like three times. He's like, that guy's got five broken ribs and a busted cuticle and a broken orbital socket.
Definitely knew what the hell. That man went to the right kind of school.
He sure did. Wow, he just poke a body and be like, you got a broken leg.
Speaking of and I guess really now, final thoughts. I mean, for me, the other thing is another thing about the gruesomeness is Centipede's. Methods of like markless methods of murder, like the freaking like gut hook,
spooky stuff,
and the brain needle where he stuck a hook like up the dude's palate,
like a straight spike up the nose,
like down his throat.
The other one, he's talking about the fish hook.
Fun stuff.
Actually, made me kind of cringe a bit.
Yeah, actually, there are some cringeworthy, but not because it was bad. Because, I mean, it was just kind of boogie.
Seriously. Awful.
And, I mean, like I said, it's not a... The plot's as complex as it... Is it more complex than it needs to be?
Kind of.
I do like that it does kind of convey a nice little air of paranoia where the main characters are definitely reacting. And sometimes they react the wrong way. They think someone's trying to target them when they're actually trying to help them, and also vice versa, that they trust people that they shouldn't easily.
Sometimes they get angry and just drink a gallon of sake, but,
tossing one back for his dead homie.
Yeah, really. But the pot was like this big. It's like 5 gallons of alcohol.
Okay. Yeah. All right, so what are we giving this?
Out of paper cranes?
Well, I would give it a... I'd give it about three. 3 out of 5. I mean, it was good. It drags a little bit in the middle, and the fake mystique, which the fake mystery, which I mean, it's not obvious, but is obvious whom the Venoms are and what they're doing.
Yeah.
All right, Roger.
I'd say a pretty solid 3-2. I like a lot of stuff. Some of the martial arts from that time period, I kind of thought fell short as opposed to some of the other stuff I've seen. But I liked it all in all, and everything, all the production value was good. I'd say it was pretty good, solid 3.
So, once again, I'm going to make a note of viewing this through the eyes, the glasses of...
Oh, my childhood, I remember these.
Yep.
Viewing it through that, I would give it a 5. Viewing it through the way I do now, as to me, it still stands up to the test of time from when I saw it when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to have to get a little lower, go a little lower than that. And I'll give it a 4 because I forgot how much the story drug when I was a kid.
Yeah.
And now watching it now, that was one of the main things that kind of brings down the score for me. So
when you're a kid, you don't follow it that close. You have like...
No, it was like, you're just like, no, you're just waiting. Yeah, when you're a kid, you're just waiting for that next scene to happen. That's just like, oh my God.
You're waiting for that next martial arts scene.
Yeah.
And I would say just really... Finally, like, is it worth watching? I mean, if you haven't seen it, it's definitely... I mean, if you're a fan of the chop sake genre, you know, the classics of chop sake.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And it's available on Netflix right now, and you can probably find it a bunch of other places.
It is. I mean, if you want to own it, you can get it really cheap on Amazon. But, I mean, it is streaming on Netflix, so...
Yep.
And they actually use the... I found out that when it was originally called The Five Deadly Venoms, that was just added to it.
Oh, so the Five Venoms is the actual original title.
It's the actual Chinese title. Yeah.
Because this is Runmei Shaw that did this one.
Well, he produced it.
Yep.
Yeah, which is, of course, he is the younger of the Shaw brothers. Yeah.
But that was always the nickname for it. And so when it was originally released, it became, instead of being the Five Venoms, because they are quite deadly, but they adapted that nickname to it, and it became the Five Deadly Venoms, and then... Once it got re-released, apparently something happened, and that whole thing was that nickname or moniker got trademarked somehow.
Huh.
It became, and then they went back to the original name of the Five Venoms because it's just five members of like the Poison Clan.
Poison Clan, yep.
Hence, where the Venom theme comes from.
And actually, like one final thing is actually there is a really neat. I mean, this is a sentiment that's actually expressed by different members of the Venoms at different times. Is the fact that they basically. They're really bitchy about the fact that their master taught them a useless martial arts skill.
Oh, yeah.
Where Toad is just like, oh, man, all I know is how to, like, get beat up.
Yeah.
I wish I had a valuable skill. So I made the comment like, oh, man, I wish I could have joined the bricklayer clan. Or the carpentry clan.
The laundry clan.
And then, like...
The accounting clan.
Yeah, ooh, that'd be a nice one. Yeah, you can do a math.
Yeah.
And then, of course, Snake...
You can be my little abacus.
And then Snake also said that, like,
I kill people.
Yeah, I mean, I joined to be this kung fu genius, and actually all I am is I'm a killer.
I come from a rich family. I don't need money. I wanted just a high martial arts skill to have, and all I do is kill people. And it's not really what I want to do, because there's a Chinese proverb, I think, once the evil deed starts, it goes on and on.
Mm-hmm. But anyways, there you have it, guys. Five Venoms. I definitely think it's a... worth checking out. I mean, even better if you watch it with a group of friends.
It is. Most things are.
All right, guys. And again, thank you. Thanks again for watching Chop Sake Cinema. Please like, share, and subscribe.
Yay.
And be watching out in the next couple of weeks. We're going to have the first installment of our East Meets West segment, where we're going to basically take a Western movie that was heavily influenced by Eastern cinema.
As many of them are.
Mm-hmm. Anyways, until next time, I'm Josh.
Roger.
Will.
And remember, ladies and gentlemen, Poison Clan rocks the world.
Woohoo!